sunbeam still splashing around down there. Okay, we're going to bring the view around so I can show you this on both sides. Don't get to see this all the time. And once they hear us, they come up and they put on a little show. Sunbeam splashing right down here. Oh, they're having a great time. Almost make you want to be a dolphin when you see this. Hey, out your left door right now, you'll see them splashing around down there. See them all down there under the water? There's a whole school of dolphin down here. Hey, we'll go past the sun glare, and you'll be able to look right down in the water and see them out your left-hand side. There you go. See them out your left? Splashing around, having a great old time. What kind of fish must be running down there today? Now I call this my theme song, Just Another Day Here in Paradise. Initially, the cliffs here formed when a big chunk dropped in. Not unusual in Hawaii. If you visit Molokai, the North Shore actually formed the same way. And on Oahu, the Ko'olau's, and over on the Big Island, it could happen again. There is a fault line running through Volcano National Park, 50 miles long. That's where all the lava flows are currently occurring. If it gives way, though, 50 miles, 3 miles wide, will go whoosh into the ocean. Leave up to 4,000 foot cliffs behind. And drive waves up 1,000 feet. Mega tsunami waves. They were featured recently on the History Channel show, Mega Disasters. And fortunately for me, my wife was sitting next to me while I was watching that. They showed a simulation of what 1,000 foot waves would look like going across each Hawaiian island. She immediately grabbed my arm and said, if mega tsunami waves were coming, you'd fly over and pick me up first, right? I looked her in the eyes and said, does this mean I get back massages again? Isn't leverage wonderful? And we can see Hanakapiai Beach. That's 1 mile in, 1 mile back. That's the farthest I've ever hiked. I couldn't see going any further. Now to our left, there's a ridge with all these finger points sticking up. Yeah, we feel the wind kind of being modified by the shape a little. We'll go past it. But the point at the end is the Bali High from the South Pacific musical. And the air smooths back out here once we get offshore. And all the helicopters go offshore here because our sound waves would really bother these people over here. People have paid millions of dollars for oceanfront property, and they don't want to hear a helicopter go by every 5 minutes. I can't blame them. I would not want to listen to that all day. So we're just kind of going off far enough where we don't bother them. There is an enormous coral reef. Now the coral and the sand are related by parrotfish. They chop away on the coral all day, and they quickly digest it in the little pebbles at an amazing rate of speed. In 1 year, one parrotfish can produce almost 1/2 ton of coral sand. Next time you're basking in the sun, laying on a beautiful Hawaiian beach, now you know, you're laying in fish poo. which is sterile and clean, just way too much information. Yeah, we didn't need to know that one, Steve. You do have to be a little careful out here in the coral reef. There's a movie called Soul Surfer, the story of Bethany Hamilton. It's over here where she lost her arm to a shark. Right, we see all those pine trees. That's the beach called Pine Trees. And that's where she was. The shark came up, thought she was a monk seal because of the shape of the board with her sitting on it. Once it realized she wasn't a monk seal, it took off, but her arm was already gone. And she still went on to become a champion surfer. Yeah, she's amazing. Straight ahead, Princeville Resort. St. Regis. To the right of it, the Hanalei River comes into Hanalei. And just to the left of the river, there's a hill with a green strip coming down. That's where the Frenchman's House was built for the South Pacific. And over here, Lumahai Beach is where Mitzi Gaynor was going to wash that man right out of her hair. And growing around Hanalei, what looks like rice paddies is taro. It's a starch like a potato, which is boiled and pounded down into poi. Has anyone sampled some of that delicious poi yet? Yeah, it's definitely an acquired taste. But I happen to find a way that I think pretty much everybody loves poi. That's by mixing it with pancake batter and make a pancake. Now that changes everything. Now it's cooked. It makes a pancake very moist with a bright pink color because of the poi. And so now it's really looking Polynesian. And then you put lily koi syrup on top. You will never want a regular pancake ever again. It's wonderful. One of my favorite restaurants over here was at the Hanalei Bay Resort. They used to have what's called a taro patch breakfast because one-third of all the taro grown in the state grows right here in Hanalei. And they'd have taro cooked like home fries, poi pancakes, lily koi syrup with eggs. I mean, it was really a wonderful breakfast. And sadly, July 1st, the restaurant burnt down. It's being repaired right now. I guess it gutted it out, but they still are able to get it back in operation. I was bummed. Apparently, they were having the roof repaired, and the roofers set the place on fire. If you're down there in Hanalei and you look uphill, you always see a waterfalls and a mountain. It's the waterfalls on Mount Molokama. In the evenings, the mist off of the mountain descends and is guided by the valley straight out to Hanalei. And if there's a full moon rising, you can see a moonbow appear, which looks like a rainbow, only white, arching across the bay. And if that doesn't get you the warmest kiss and a hug you've ever had, nothing else is going to do the job. Very romantic. What a beautiful spot. And from here, we head into Hanalei Valley. Hanalei River gets its water from Mount Waialeale. So we're going to follow it back to that source and actually go visit the crater itself. Now in the valley itself, you may notice the trees here with the bright green leaf. That's our state tree, kukui nut. Kukui means light or candle. The nut was burned like a candle. And the oil that's in the shell was a beauty product for the ladies of Hawaii. It would keep their hair shiny, their skin smooth. It's also fragrant. That would be their perfume. It's also edible. Wouldn't recommend eating any. If you eat kukui nut, you will make an amazing discovery. You just ate the world's strongest laxative. One nut, you're walking fast. Two nuts, you're trotting. By three, you're setting a new land speed record to a guava tree. That just happens to be the only known antidote for kukui nut in the wild. Now tell me this isn't prior planting. Wherever you've got kukui nut growing, guava's the next tree. Hawaiians really planned ahead. And they take an annual climb up here to the top of Mount Waialeale once a year. It's a treacherous climb. So to calm their nerves along the way, they would chant something that would later be translated to English. It's now the most famous poem on the island. And it goes like this: beautiful Kauai beyond compare. She sends forth bud in the summit of Waialeale. She flowers in the heights of Kawakine. Her strength radiates in the power of the Alakai. And though I weary and though I faint, she renews my strength in her soft petals. There's a lot of water coming down this mountain today on all the different sides. I'm just letting the other helicopter jump into the crater first, and then we'll go take a view. And the entranceway to the crater is just up ahead. It's such a beautiful place here that, well, my voice would only be a distraction. And so it's the only part of our tour where we just let the music and the scenery do all the talking. Welcome to the crater of Mount Waialeale. Wasn't that a beautiful place? Beautiful waterfalls everywhere we look today. Wouldn't that be nice standing at the bottom of that waterfall with the water just pounding down? And straight ahead, you can see there's a ridge near the ocean with a point in the middle. And if you begin at the point and slope down to the left, that's the outline of the sleeping giant. The high point's his forehead. Then you can see it slopes to the left to his chin sticking up, over to his chest where his arms are folded, down to the hips and the legs straight out. Everybody see that? The sleeping giant. Yeah, the legend is he had too much poi, laid down to sleep it off, been there ever since. We call that Hawaiian paralysis, which you get to experience at any good Hawaiian luau. Now you can see all the green grassy areas up ahead. This used to be all sugarcane fields. Now, grazing area for cattle. Cows have a very unusual name in Hawaii. They're called pipis because the first cows were longhorns, gifts to Kamehameha from George Vancouver, brought here in 1793. Before they arrived, there were pigs on the island, which Hawaiians call pua'as. And because that was the only thing they had to compare these new animals with, when they saw the longhorns, they were called pua'a pipi auhau, or pigs with big iron ears. Slowly over time, that got reduced down to pipi, and that's why cows are pipis in Hawaii. Cowboys, or paniolos. Our first cowboys were Spanish-speaking from Mexico. Hawaiians couldn't pronounce the word Espanol. There's no ES pronunciation in the Hawaiian language. So the closest they got to Espanol, Paniolo, the name that stuck. And I always point this out because there's a very good chance visiting the Garden Isle of Kauai, you might bump into a Paniolo, there's a lot of them here, and you might ask him what he does all day. I don't want you to be shocked when he tells you he chases his pee-pee around. Good thing to know, he's talking about cows at that moment. Learning Hawaiian saves embarrassment. Sad looking up and seeing Lihue Airport get closer. Yeah, towers cleared us into the airspace. Hawaiians say, Uahala nakapuna ahi iki koleoliu vala nako ke iala inamea ike awe hopililo iu kikilo, which translated means the ancestors of Hawaii have long since passed on. Today's people visiting see a glimpse of that time long ago and far behind. And I really enjoyed being the one to share a glimpse of that flying around with you. I like to think everyone goes from friendship to family in one flight. And look how fast my family grows. But you could do me a favor, please recommend Sunshine to family and friends. Best advertising, word of mouth. And we're also found on the Big Island in Maui if you happen to get over there. And thought we'd have a nice landing song. How about if Louis Armstrong sings a song?
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Kauai Beach Resort. Yeah, we do want to stay buckled up all the way till we land. After touching down, our folks will come out to help offload. You always want to exit to the front, never the rear, because of the tail rotor spinning so fast it's invisible. And they'll get you safely outside. I get busy talking to them for landing here on behalf of Sunshine. Aloha, mahalo, ahuiho, malama pono. Please take care of yourselves until the next time we meet. So pretty inside. Aloha, everybody. Have a great time here.
Also on the faces.
You think it's possible to time it so we touch down right when Louis Armstrong finishes this song? Let's see how close we get. Isn't timing everything? Thank you. It's my pleasure. I have just as much fun out there. And James coming out, he'll open the doors and get you safely outside. It just takes a lift of the buckle to release the safety belts. And our headsets, if you don't mind. In the back seat, there's a railing to hang them up. I can take the ones up front for you. And we'll just get those cords out of your way. Perfect, just like that. Aloha, my pleasure. Thank you. Aloha. Aloha. Enjoy yourselves here. Aloha. My pleasure.